One of my favorite things about our Doosan Lynx lathe is the fact that it has a subspindle capable of part handling operations. What that means is I can put a piece of raw stock in our main spindle, and the subspindle, when the turning is finished on the first side, the subspindle can come over, grab the part, and then we have access to finish the backside. So I put a raw piece of material in and take out a finished part without any human interaction. At this point, my Mastercam file isn't configured yet to take advantage of this subspindle. Because I'm using mill turn functionality in lathe, I'm able to simulate this entire pickoff operation. The first thing I need to do, though, is install my subspindle jaws into my Mastercam file. I've gone ahead and saved a model of the chuck jaws as a step file, which is needed to import them into the component library. So in this instance of CodeXpert, I need to open my generic Fanuc inch GMD. When this session of Mastercam opens, this is going to allow me to import a model of my chuck jaws. So in this session of Mastercam that opens, we have the chuck jaws group already has our main spindle soft jaws. Here I will right click and say add chuck jaws. I already have a solid entity here, so I'm going to say solid entity. And in this case, I want to browse externally to find this file. So let's say open component model and subjaw. Even though this jaw is going to be used in the subspindle, we have to define it as though the mounting face is on the left, as if we're using it on the main spindle. So let's choose a face that defines how the jaw mates to the chuck, and then slide our dynamic gnomon to this arc center. This orientation is correct. Click OK. And now we see a model of our chuck jaw. On the second page, make sure we are set to an OD clamping. And also, let's make sure that the reference point here is on this face somewhere. This reference point on the face of the jaws defines the Z coordinate where the subspindle position will be measured relative to the part. We can finally name our chuck jaws. And save our component library. Again, it's a good habit to turn off all your levels, reopen your machine definition, and save your component library once more so it opens in a blank state the next time you use it. Now back in the CodeXpert window, we see the inch GMD file has an asterisk saying this file needs to be saved. So let's save this .machine file and go back into our Mastercam file. In the Job Setup tab, we now have the opportunity to change the jaws in our right spindle. Right-click Chuck Jaws and say Select New. And here we can choose the Twin Flow Chuck Jaws. We see the profile updated on our screen. And there are a couple other changes we need to make here. As of right now, this job is set up to have no pickoff. We want a single piece of stock with a pickoff, meaning the subspindle will come grab the part and slide back over for some more machining. Next, I'll say we'll keep the right spindle geometry on the same level as the left. Really nothing else in here is going to change except for maybe this pickoff position. We need to verify, again, this is that reference point we were talking about before, where we need to choose the point where that reference point will land. So let's just say here, for example, I'll even round this up a little bit just so that it doesn't interfere with that fillet. Say okay. And finally, let's regenerate the dirty operations. In the part handling gallery of the turning tab, we can choose pickoff. These pickoff and other part handling routines come pre-configured in our .machine file, meaning they don't need any further interaction. I can simply click OK. the part handling operations all generate inline. One thing I really like to do in this case is step through the part handling operation with my Mastercam cursor. So as I step through this, we can see all of the steps that come inside of this part handling operation. So first, the turret parks. Second, the subspindle unclamps and the stock is ejected. The spindles are then synchronized. The subspindle rapids to a reference position and then feeds to its clamping position. The subspindle clamps and the stock is transferred to the subspindle. The main spindle unclamps, the spindles desynchronize, and the subspindle moves back home, ready to be programmed. At this point, let's add a simple roughing operation to our subspindle side. Let's choose rough. In this case, we can use solid chaining. So I'll chain from the beginning of this chamfer up to the end of this fillet. We already have a tool defined here. We're in the upper right quadrant of this machine, meaning an upper turret on the right spindle. And we're machining to remaining stock. There's our roughing operation. Now let's run this through the simulator. Select all operations, click post. We can now launch the simulation. So now let's step through this process. First, we see all the operations happening on the left side of the machine. Our OD turning. Our drilling and our boring. And finally, the milling ops. After this deburr operation, the turret will park in a safe position. The subspindle will unclamp, synchronize, and there's our pickoff operation. Next, we're going to see the tool change to our roughing tool, and then our subspindle roughing operation will run. Our Doosan Lynx machine is capable of what's called a torque skip pickoff, meaning the subspindle will physically bump into the part until torque is detected before clamping. What that's going to do is allow us to really control the Z length of our part consistently, meaning that we're picking off from the same exact point on the part each time. So to activate that, I'll go to our machine group settings and toggle activate torque skip mode. The final step in this process is to simply click post. Now that we've posted the code, we can set the work offset for our subspindle and run it. We'll be right back. So here we have our finished Twin Flow Impeller blank. Thanks to this great dot machine file we have for our Doosan Lynx lathe, we were able to simulate this entire process left and right, including the pickoff operation, all in Mastercam. Now I'm going to hand this part over to Jesse for some blade expert work.
Thanks, Chad. So great looking blank. We're ready to do some milling on our Akuma with the Nikon rotary. And I'm actually going to start by roughing this out in a more conventional approach using 3+2 milling and then some full blown multi-axis to finish. After that, we'll move over into some blade expert operations and really take this to the next level. So stay tuned.